Hello, it's Sarah. And tonight I have a couple of things to share. I've been trying to make things for my craft show. It's November 2nd, and I usually just bring whatever I've made that year. I don't plan for it necessarily ahead of time. But then as it gets closer, I do start to feel it's like crunch time a little bit. And I want to definitely make sure I have things. Like, I have tons of keychains. I'm going to bring bookmarks. I didn't have any mini albums. So that's what brings me to today's video. But first, I wanted to talk about, I made a few more of those little totes that you make with the envelope totes. And I was thinking about doing them for teachers' gifts because Maya just started second grade. And, you know, a lot of times people just want to give the teacher a little gift. So I had these, I had kind of snagged some of the Starbucks. I think these are from the green ones. These are the, you know, the cup holders that you get at Starbucks. So I kind of just put some school paper, thought I could put that in there. What else was that? I'm going to cover a couple of those little composition books. You know, just little things that you could put in here for a teacher's gift. So I made a couple of them. They're nothing, you know, fancy. I just put school paper on them basically, and some stickles and some, you know, glossy accents and stuff. So real simple, but I just thought that, I mean, even if people didn't put the things that I put in there, they could stuff them with their own stuff and kind of give those as teacher's gifts. So as I was thinking about that, I thought a notebook of some. I've seen little videos with people put post-it notes. That's what it was. There was one with a post-it note holder inside, like a little, with a bind it all binding with post-its in it. So that got me thinking. And then, so this is where I'm going with that. So this is kind of what my version of it was. I didn't put post-it notes in here, but I was playing with my bind it all. These file folders are really actually good quality. These were from the dollar store. I think you got 10 for a dollar, and they're really nice quality. So I wanted to get them anyway because I could use them for ATC backs and things like that. But I ended up making this little kind of a notebook. It's a notebook slash, you know, I have, and I made it in the size that I thought would fit in here if I did want to do it that way too. I'm not sure yet. I'm still debating, and I think I am going to do the composition books instead. I think they're littler, because I ended up doing something different. But this was the idea I got. Like, this is an ATC size card, right? So I cut this out. It's also the size of a school picture. So I wanted to kind of make something that a school picture would fit in the pocket, not necessarily in the pocket, but on the pages too, like a mat size. So definitely a school picture would fit on these pages. So this one has, it's just, I think I put 3 pocket pages and 5 pages in between that are actually lined paper. One side of them is lined paper. Just paper that I had in my stash just to play around and see if I remembered how to use my bind at all. And that's what I came up with for that. But then that morphed into what I'm going to show you now that I'm really loving. So these I'll have at my craft show and we'll see how it goes. I mean, you know, they're pretty cute. But, you know, remember these ATCs I made? I really, really love these. And I hadn't stopped playing with the corrugated card necessarily. I was still making the boxes, the pizza boxes. I actually have one here that I still want to do. You know, I had shared a couple of the other ones that I did. So that brought me to this, which was what I came up with for the little notebooks. Now, since I did the first one, it changed and changed and changed. It's morphed like 3 times to now where I'm finally kind of thinking I'm good with it. I like it. I like the construction of it. Let me see. This is actually the first one I made. I ended up putting a 1-inch binding ring on here after I took the 3/4 inch off because it was very bulky. I ended up putting 3 pocket pages, and I think, let's see how many pages. 3 pages in between each pocket page. 4 pages. 4 pages in between each pocket page. So that's a lot of pages. The paper I used is actually from AC Moore, and it was a dollar. You got like about 10 sheets, 15 sheets, I forget. And I liked the colors, but it was kind of thin, the paper. And so it's weird because when you put paper on top of it, it all bulks it up. So anyway, that was the first one I made. I love the cover, and I inked everything. I inked the edges. I just used, you know what it's called. Here goes my brain again. I have no memory. What is this called? You guys know this color paper. I'm totally blank. But anyway, that's my base cardstock that I use. Just craft, thank you. Craft cardstock. To create the book, I used the corrugated card for the covers, and I just backed it with a piece of file folder. I put, like, you can't see it on here. I'm gonna do a tutorial because I just think it's super cute. So this was the first one I made, and I put an inch binding ring, which is, I mean, it didn't come out too straight either, which I wasn't pleased with, but I like it. I like the cover a lot. I think it turned out cute. Then this is the second one I made, which I was much happier with. I went with, this was another of that paper that I got, which was a dollar. So, I mean, this is very thin paper. Let's see how many pages I did. I think I only put 2 pages. So, I did pocket page, 2 pages. So, that's how that one turned out. The 3/4 inch, the 3/4 of an inch binding ring is pretty good on that. Like, it didn't get too fat. But the thing is, that was a thin paper. This is a thin paper, and it's just, again, the craft cardstock. And I didn't embellish it at all. I backed the covers with to make them stiffer with the file folder, and used the 3/4 inch binding ring. So then this one, I changed it up a little. I went with the black cards. I ran out of craft. I didn't have enough craft, and I didn't feel like going out today because I have to go out and do some stuff tomorrow, and I'll get more. But I had plenty of black, so I wanted to make black, and I also pulled some of my paper pads. So this is Primrose. I think this is the Primrose stack. The tutorial I'm going to do, I'm using the Butterfly Garden stack. I just pulled some old papers that I had that were just sweet, that weren't like real, you know, I mean, they're just sweet papers. I just like them. But this one was way fatter because this paper is just thicker. Just that alone makes the pages, because I only did 2 pages, pocket page, 1, 2 pages, pocket page, 2 pages, pocket page. So I think I only have, I don't know. I mean, it's about the same, but this one needed the inch binding rings. And I figure once people start putting things in there, it'll puff up more. So anyway, that's what I came up with. So I'm gonna do a tutorial. It's basically 3.5 by 4.5 inch mini album. So it's kind of small, which this one, the one I'm going to do the tutorial on, I think I've even changed it up a little more to where it's just going to have 2 pocket pages with 2 pages in between each one. So I really want to use the 3/4 inch binding rings. So I've gone ahead and I've completed most of the album, and then I'm going to just show you how to assemble the pocket page and give you all the size measurements and things like that. I used wet glue to assemble these, and I'm just going to show you. See, I left this so I could show you that it's actually backed with a piece of file folder, but this just has cover, 2 pages, pocket page, 2 pages, pocket page, and 2 pages. So it's a little bit less, if you don't know, but because I just really want to try using the 3/4 inch, like I used the 3/4 inch binding ring on there. See how it's approximately the same size? All right, so I'm gonna come back and I'll do a little tutorial. It won't be long because I did most of the work already. All right, thanks for watching.